what do we have here? The Marshall JVM 410 combo amplifier. Good night. What is all this stuff? And no, I don't drive a lifted four-wheeler or a sports car. We'll be right back. Hi all, welcome to Rock Hard Riffs. This is the guitar channel for the self-taught. Today we're going to dial in two channels, the first two channels, the clean and the crunch of the Marshall JVM 410 combo. Now I know what you're thinking, look at all the knobs on that thing, what is with that? Come on man. It really is simple and I'm going to show you all about it, okay? So let's zoom in and we're going to take a look at what does what, and then we're going to go over the first two channels. All right, guys, let's start with the master section on the right. Now, what you see there is presence and resonance. That works like a big, fat boost when you kick that thing in. So you don't really need a boost with this. Also, you'll notice that there are two master volumes on the bottom right there. Okay, so you'll see why the two master volumes. It's very, very cool. If you don't understand why there would be two masters, you'll see why really quick. Also, we have individual reverbs for each channel, and those are digital reverbs. It's like a room reverb, I do believe, and it's absolutely awesome. The reverb sounds great on this thing. So now as we pan over, we're going to see overdrive one and overdrive two. Okay, so overdrive two is like a heavy metal type of channel, and the overdrive one is heavy metal and hard rock. So I do 9/10 of my hard rock stuff through the OD1, but I'm starting to use the crunch more and more and more. I'll tell you guys, this crunch channel alone, these amps go for just under 3,000 new, but you'll never pay that for them. But anyway, this crunch channel alone is almost worth that price, and I'm not joking. Let's so, take a look at the clean channel, and I'm going to operate the foot switch remotely, and we'll go over this. Let's talk a little bit about the clean channel. Okay, clean green mode. This is the cleanest of the three modes, and in keeping with traditional clean amps, it uses a simple and straightforward circuit, keeping the signal as pure as possible. In this mode, the channel's volume control is taken out of circuit and is in the case in vintage amplifiers of this nature. This is the only JVM mode where this happens. Now, what happens, guys, if you notice on the left is the gain on the clean channel is on the left is a gain knob. That works as your volume in the clean green, and then it works as like overdrive in the yellow and red, and you're going to hear both of those, okay? And I'm just really starting to discover the clean red mode. I'm going to show you some cool stuff through it. I think you'll like it. Now, next is clean orange. By adding another gain stage after the tone stack, we get a punchier sound that's easy to overdrive. As in the rest of the modes, the channel's volume control is now active. That's what I was just mentioning to you. Then there's the clean red. This mode pushes the original clean sound even more and transforms itself into a pseudo high gain channel with the addition of yet another gain stage after the tone stack. In keeping with classic clean amps of yesteryear, all three modes of this channel feature what is known as a pre-gain tone stack, i.e. the tone network lies before the channel's main gain stage. The reverse, i.e. the tone network being after the main gain stage, is typical of most Marshalls, and as a result, the clean channel's tone controls work in a slightly different way than you might expect. In addition to controlling the tone of the channel, they also affect how it reacts in terms of gain, allowing you to shape how the signal distorts. For example, turning up the middle control on higher gain settings will focus distortion there. making your sound sing in a traditional blues rock way. Also because of the channel's tone then gain topology, when a lot of gain is dialed in, especially in the case of the red mode, it may appear that the tone controls aren't doing as much as you'd expect, or sound over distorted. This is because the signal is being distorted after the tone stage, minimizing the effectiveness of bass, middle, and treble controls. Now guys, you're really gonna notice that when I compare the clean channel to the crunch channel, okay? Now you're just gonna be surprised. Okay, now right now, as you can see, the green on the bottom left, that little light, we're in clean green. Okay, and I'm on both pickups and the guitar. Okay, let's listen to a little song. Just to give you an idea how beautiful this clean is. Very nice, right? Let's listen to a couple chords. Okay, so you got a good idea of the clean green there. Now, this is where the master volumes come in, because the tone stacks are different and the gain stacks and all this stuff is different. The volumes come out different when, let's say, I go to clean orange. Okay? Now the volume, the gain knob that you see there is for overdrive and the volume is for the actual volume. So I'm going to turn up the gain. And let's take a look at what we've got here, okay? So now we're right here. I'm gonna turn this up. I'm gonna turn that gain up so we can have a little more hair on there. Listen to that difference. It's also, you know, adds more volume too, of course. Cool. Now let's check out the red. This is what they're calling a pseudo high gain. This channel right here. Now, I just made that T-Rex video the other day. I was thinking, gosh, once I started messing with this before I was making this video, I should have used the clean red for that. Listen to this tone, okay? So it starts. So yeah, that's kind of a cool tone, isn't it? Now, let's talk about EQ. Okay, now like on my previous video that I made of the Orange Crush, we talked a lot about equalization. Now, just knowing these amps, guys, this comes in, we're entering a different ball game when we start doing what we're doing now. Okay, I'm going to start using my tone control a lot more with an amp like this because I have so many different potential tones. So start thinking that way. Use that tone control to knock back nasty brash treble if you have any. Okay, but now Marshalls tend to be kind of brash and bright. So you, as you notice, I have my treble set even on both channels at about 12 o'clock because I can add more and take more, just like we were talking about before. We can take away from this position or add, and I can do even more with this tone knob on my guitar, okay? So that's when this is really important. Now, mids cut through. You've got to have mid-range to cut through. I would really, you know what Eddie Van Halen does is he has this whole thing dimed. Or in the old days, that's how he did it. He had the whole thing dimed out. I am over my 12 o'clock positions on the mid and bass. I like a nice kick in that bass, and I've got it in there if you, as you notice. I want to add some mid-range on this to cut through. Now, as I'm showing you this, guys, the way I think of my equipment and stuff is not for a YouTube channel. It's for playing live. Now, this is a live, you know, this is a stage amp is what this is, and it covers the gamut of tones. You go from absolutely perfectly clean to the nastiest, raunchiest of heavy metal tones in the overdrive to red. So you have everything in between, and that's the beauty of this amp, is the flexibility that it gives you. Even in one channel alone, we go from beautiful clean to crunchy to hard rock. Pseudo, that's like an AC/DC tone right there. And we're just in channel one. Okay? Now, let's move on to the crunch channel. Let's go into crunch green. As you can see, I have the EQs about the same. I have a good heavy amount of bit of gain on there. And the reason I have that there is because, you know, I use different guitars. And this just works better for me right there. If I need to cut back on the gain a little bit, all I have to do is just cut back on my volume a little bit. Okay? If I want that back. And again, as you can see, I like to have a decent amount of volume in there, channel volume, because I want to drive the tubes. If I'm playing out live, it's going to be a lot higher than that, I guarantee you. So, all right, let's go over the tones and sounds of the crunch channel. Now you're going to notice that the gain stages are kind of similar, but we have different tones, which is very, very cool. Okay. So this is crunch green. Okay, cool. Now let's go to, now we're in yellow, and also I just changed the master volumes. I went from the A to the B master volume. And that's preset. This thing remembers all of that. Every time I touch the foot switch, it remembers what master volume I was using, if the reverb was on or off, etc. So that's very cool, presets. Now what you do is you have to level off your volumes so they come off level, and that's where the master volumes come in. So your master volume might be set at X level on crunch green. But because crunch yellow has more gain on it, it's going to be louder. So I use the master volume B to reduce the volume. That's the beauty of that. Okay, so now I have equalized volumes. Now also you can use that master volume B or A, whichever you want, as a boost to cut through for like solos and leads and stuff like that. So that's the points of those master volumes. Now let's listen to crunch yellow, and I'm on the bridge pickup of the guitar. Okay, now let's check out crunch red. As you can hear, more gain. Okay. Sweet. So those are the three tones. Now let's read a little bit and see what Marshall has to say about the crunch channel. Okay, at this point, the JVM reverts to the more typical Marshall preamp circuit characteristic of gain, then tone. This is also true of the OD1 and OD2 channels. Crunch green mode, this mode shares the preamp topology of the classic Marshall JTM45 1959 Plexi models, i.e. gain plus tone, but with more of gain than is found in the originals. So more gain than the original Plexi. So that's very cool. That's crunch green. That right there alone, guys, that channel alone. Incredible. Let's go to orange. This mode is more reminiscent of the Marshall JCM-800-2203 amplifier, a staple of hard rock. The gain structure is gain, plus gain, plus gain, plus tone. Now crunch red. This shares the topology of the orange mode, but with more gain. Amazing. Giving you sounds similar to a hot-rodded JCM-800. So that explains the crunch channel on this. Now I want you to listen to something. I want you to listen. We're in the crunch red. Okay, now that's supposed to be like a hot-rodded JCM-800. Now let's go to the clean red. Just a different tone, but still hard rocking. That's clean red. Let's go to crunch red. Crunch red, now green red. Different tones. Now also, this is OD1, just real quickly so you can hear it, OD1 green. Which is supposed to be very similar to the crunch red. A JCM-800. Now you ask, why would we have two different modes or channels that contain a JCM-800? Okay, you might have one that has more overdrive or more distortion. One could be cleaner, the other could be brighter, one could be muddier for rhythm. You can set the tones, your EQs, differently for those two modes and still have the same kind of sound, but a different tone. So the different variations, the flexibility of this amp are like, you know, mind-boggling sometimes. It's so awesome. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed this. Please subscribe. We're going to make at least one more video, and that's gonna go OD1, OD2, and then the master section and the foot switch we have to go to. So this is a labor of love, these videos, because you know it's working me as much as I'm working it. So I really hope you guys enjoy this. And please subscribe. We really need your subscription, folks. So we know that you enjoy what we're doing, that you get something out of it, because that is the entire point. If nobody gets anything out of this or doesn't enjoy it, what's the point, right? Okay, guys, thanks so much. Again, this is Rock Hard Riffs, and we will see you next video.